Hello friends, in this video we will learn what is meant by serial adder. Let us begin. Let's start with serial adder. In the previous video, I have already explained a parallel adder. I hope you must have seen that video, then this makes sense to see a serial adder also. In parallel adder, for 4-bit addition, we require 4 full adders, am I right? For 5-bit addition, again we will require 5 full adders, meaning that if the size of the number keeps on increasing, size of the hardware will also keep on increasing. So we have seen in parallel adder, for n-bit addition, we need n full adders. In contrast to serial adder, in serial addition, since even though the size of number is n bit, only 1-bit addition takes place at a time, therefore we require only 1 full adder. That can be considered as advantage of serial adder over a parallel adder. But then the thing is, parallel adder would be faster as compared to serial adder. Because in serial addition, even though the size of the number is n bit, only 1 bit is added at a time. Meaning that, first of all, LSB will get added, its sum and carry is stored somewhere. After that, the previous sum will be added with next 2 bits, that is A1, B1, let's say. Then A2, B2 along with C2 carry addition takes place. In this case, only 1 bit addition takes place at a time, therefore it takes time as compared to parallel addition. Now, let us see serial addition in detail. So, as I said, even though it is for n bit addition, we require only 1 full adder. So, let us understand with the help of 4 bit addition. So now we will see how serial adder is taking care of 4-bit addition. 4-bit addition means again you are going to add 2 numbers, which is A and B, and size of A and B individually will be 4-bit in size. So size of number A will be 4-bit, that is A3, A2, A1, A0, and size of number B is also 4-bit, which is B3, B2, B1, B0. Assuming number A as well as number B are stored in a shift register. What is meant by shift register? Shift register means a collection of flip-flops, where one flip-flop acts as 1-bit memory cell, meaning that one flip-flop can hold only 1-bit. So to hold 2-bit, you require how many flip-flops? Of course, 2 flip-flops. To hold 3-bit, you require 3 flip-flops. In order to get 4-bit storage area, we require 4 flip-flops together. So this collection of 4 flip-flops makes it one shift register. So here I have shown 2 shift registers. So the first shift register stores the value of A. So we have number A in first shift register and number B in second shift register. We'll see how. Here A3, A2, A1 and A0 are stored. In number B shift register, as you can see, it is B3, B2, B1 and B0, these are the numbers to be stored. Now, as you can see, there is a clock arrangement also given, because shift registers cannot give you data until and unless the clocks are also given. So, the duty of number A shift register to provide you A0 here. The same time, this shift register provides B0 here. Assuming initially 1-bit memory is clear, it provides you by default input as 0. I'm sure you remember 4-bit addition, in which we first of all add A0, B0 along with C0, but the value of C0 should be 0 initially. After addition of A0, B0 and C0, what really happens is sum is generated, which is S1, and carry is generated as C1. So sum is generated as S1 and the carry generated as C1. Is that right? Now, what happens, the moment you now apply a clock pulse, this C1 will get transferred to output. But then, right now, C1 is stored in 1-bit memory cell, right? Let us assume C1 is stored in 1-bit memory cell. At the same time, the sum is now stored in 4-bit shift register, which is made for sum. So this shift register, also known as, let's say, sum shift register. So the duty of this shift register to hold the value of sum. So what happens is, right now only S1 is stored and rest of the shift register are containing 000. So assuming initially the value of these were 0000. So on first clock pulse, as we have seen, S1 is stored at MSB side and rest of the bits are equal to 0. Now what happens? If the second clock pulse is given now, then this A0 will be replaced with A1, this B0 will get replaced with B1, and then what happens, the C1 which was given over here gets transferred over here. So what gets added over here is C1 now. Therefore, now A1, B1, C1 are applied, which results in full 4-bit addition as S2 and C2, that is generation of S2 and C2. So after S1, what is given is S2. So once the S2 is given, then according to the shift register property, the data now keeps shifting to the right position. Therefore, now S1 gets shifted to the right, the 0 gets shifted to the right, the 0 gets shifted to the right, and on MSB position, what is stored is S2 now. Right? Then, when the next clock pulse is given, then A1, B1 gets replaced with A2, B2, as well as C1 gets replaced with C2 now. So let us see 4-bit addition by serial adder. As I said earlier, for 4-bit parallel addition, you require 4 full adders. Whereas for 4-bit addition or 5-bit addition or 6-bit addition, this parallel adder will keep on increasing the number of full adders. But in case of serial addition, you require only 1 full adder irrespective what is the size of addition. So how this is done, I'll just give you a demonstration for 4-bit first. Now I consider this as shift register A. Let me consider this as shift register B. And this is shift register for holding the value of sum. What is meant by shift register? A shift register is a group of flip-flops together. A flip-flop is a 1-bit memory cell which can hold only 1 bit at a time, that is either 1 or 0. It means in order to hold 2 bits, you require how many shift registers? Of course, 2 shift registers. To hold 3 bit, you require 3 shift registers and so on. That is for holding 4 bit, you require 4-bit shift register or 4-bit flip-flops, and a group of 4 flip-flops makes 1 shift register. Therefore, I am saying this as shift register which is going to hold a value of A which is 4-bit in size. So what is the value of A? It is A3, A2, A1, A0. So assuming the value of A as A3, A2, A1, A0. Next, the value of B would be B3, B2, B1, B0. Am I right? And at the output side, as you can see, there is another shift register placed for holding the value of sum, which is also 4-bit in size at the end of addition. So now I'll explain you what is going to happen with this. First of all, only A0, B0 as well as C0 will be applied. I'm sure you remember C0 means initial carry. That is, since we are adding this way, A3, A2, A1, A0, we need to add this with B3, B2, B1, B0. Since we are doing only serial addition, we add only 1 bit at a time. That is, A0 and B0 along with C0 will be added. Answer will be S1 and carry will be C1. After that, our duty is to add A1, C1, B1. So you get sum S2 and carry C2. Then A2, B2, C2 are added together. Sum S3 is generated and C3 is a carry generated. And thereafter, after addition of A3, B3 along with C3, it gives you sum S4 and final carry as C4. Is that right? Therefore, this is a final sum which is 4-bit and this is a final carry. We have done the same thing in 4-bit parallel adder. The same thing I'm going to do in serial addition, but in serial addition only one addition is performed at a time, whereas in 4-bit full adder all the additions were working in a parallel fashion. And that's the reason why I said that a serial addition would be bit slower as compared to parallel addition. As you can also see in this diagram that everything is controlled with clock. If everything is working along with a clock, since so far we are actually learning combinational logic circuit, but in combinational logic circuit, remember, the clock is not required. The moment clock enters into a combinational logic circuit, it means it is no more combinational logic circuit. This is the, in fact, example of sequential logic circuit. So now this is actually a sequential circuit because it is working along with the clock and it is including all shift registers, flip-flop and all, right? So here, on application of every clock, these additions are going to take place. That is, first of all, as you can concentrate, A0, B0 and C0 will get added at first clock. So this happens at first clock. Then A1, C1, B1 addition happens at second clock. A2, B2, C2 addition takes place at third clock. And of course, A3, B3 and C3 addition takes place at fourth clock. So in a way, for 4-bit addition, we require how many clocks? 4 clocks. It means to have 5-bit addition, you require how many clocks? 5 clocks. So in general, for n-bit addition, using a serial fashion, you require n clocks to happen this. So let's see what happens. As you can see, a clock is provided to all shift registers along with a 1-bit memory cell. This 1-bit memory cell is actually going to hold a carry at a time. It is going to hold a 1-bit carry at a time, because every time you do a sum, you generate sum along with carry. Now, whatever carry that you have generated now, you require it the same when you are performing the next stage addition. So while performing the next stage addition, a previous carry will be considered for addition purpose. So we'll see now how it works. On application of first clock pulse, what comes here is A0. What comes here is, of course, B0. And assuming the initially 1-bit memory cell were clear, therefore what comes over here is 0 after application of clock pulse. Once this happens, A0, B0 and 0, which is representing C0, after addition, what sum comes is S0. Is that right? So what comes over here is S0. Therefore, S0 enters into first shift register. Other shift registers were 0. Initially, we assume that shift register of sum was clear state. So after addition, now S0 has come, as well as carry has also come, which is C0. Right? It shouldn't be C1. It should not be C0, it should be C1, in fact, because C0 is a carry which was actually 0 initially. Once this is done, we apply a second clock pulse. Observe what happens at second clock pulse. A1, B1 and C1 should get added. Am I right? So now we will see what happens is, on application of second clock pulse, now the place of A0 will be taken with A1. Place of B0 will be taken by B1. And of course, this C1 gets transferred here. So this 0 is replaced with C1. So as you can see, now A1, B1 and C1 are added. So after addition of A1, B1 and C1, the sum comes, which is S1. Therefore, a new sum has come, which is S1. Now what is going to happen in shift register? This shift register will keep on shifting the data to the right bit. Therefore, now this S0 will be replaced with S1. And S0 gets shifted here. Am I right? This time, a carry C2 has come and gets stored into 1-bit memory cell. So now C2 is already stored inside. We require this C2 for further addition when I'm adding A2 and B2. So in the next clock pulse, what is going to happen? Instead of A1, B1 and C1, who is going to come now? A2, B2 and C2. We'll see how. This time, A1 will be replaced with A2, B1 will be replaced with B2 and C1 will be replaced with C2. So now A1 has come here, B1 has come here and C2. So A2 comes here, B2 comes here, and C2, which was stored in 1-bit memory cell, comes over here. Now, A2, B2, C2 has come, which is going to generate a sum called as S2 and carry as C3. Therefore, now S2 has come here. So, S2 takes place of S1, S1 takes place of S0, and so on, they get shifted to the right. So, a new position can be shown as, so what comes here is S2, S1 and S0, and a new carry has come, which is C3 now. So, what has come over here is C3, and this time in 1-bit memory cell, what is stored is C3. On application of next clock pulse, of course, A2, B2 will be replaced with A3, B3, and C2 will get replaced with C3. And so on, this addition goes on. After 4 clock pulses, what is the scenario? After 4 clock pulses, as you can see, A3, B3 will be input, and along with that, C3 will be input of the carry. And after addition of A3, B3 and C3, a sum will come as S4 and carry will be C4. Therefore, at the end, what picture you will see is like this. At the end of 4 clock pulses, it will be S3, S2, S1, S0 is the final sum, which is stored in shift register, and a final carry will be considered as C4. So, C4 will be considered as a final carry, which will get stored into a 1-bit memory cell. So, at the end, 1-bit memory cell will store a final carry, and S3, S2, S1, S0 is a 4-bit sum, which is holded by a shift register, which was reserved for holding the sum. So, I'm sure you have understood this 4-bit serial adder. Now, one more thing. For every clock, as you can see, only 1-bit addition is taking place. For 2 clocks, you can see only 2-bit will get added. It means to carry out 4-bit addition, you require how many clock pulses? 4 clock pulses, am I right? Assuming one clock period is T. One clock period, if it is T in length, in seconds of course, then for 4 clock pulses, you require how much time? That is 4 times T. So, what we are going to discuss over here is a propagation delay for serial addition. Or to make it very simple, it is nothing but what we are learning is time taken by serial adder. So, time taken by serial adder depends on the time period of a clock. So, every clock have got some time period. So, this is what we called as T in seconds. For 4-bit addition, number of clocks required will be how much? 4. So, total time in that case will be 4 times T. That is in terms of second. So, if for 4-bit addition, the time required is 4T, it means for n-bit addition, you require how much time? That is n times T. So, these are the basics of serial adder. I'm sure you have understood what is the principal working of serial adder and how serial addition takes place. Thank you.